To the fire station.
Where are you going, Father? And what are you going to see there? Yay, have a good time. Love you.
Bye.
Give me Slappy Five. Cool, dude. Awesome.
This is a
charm. Love you. Okay, have fun.
You ready to go to fire station?
Yeah.
I'm so psyched. Okay, bye. I want you to have a good time seeing those fire trucks. Okay. That's right.
Hi, Father.
Everything. They have everything there. Ambulance. Rescue vehicles. Right?
Is that your favorite?
And
fire trucks.
Okay, love you. Bye. Bye, sweetie. Pink
lampshade David. Thank you. You have to go.
All right, be good
now.
Tell
the fireman
I said
hello.
So,
what do you think?
Yeah.
Huh?
We'll check.
Is this as big as your fire truck?
I don't want to go under the fire truck,
right? No. Look at me, big smile. Look at me, give me a big smile. Say, hey, dude.
So that's a work in progress. All right, my friend. Wait this way.
Okay, Connor. This is the way you wanted to see, buddy.
Look at this thing. Here it is, the monolith.
What do you think of that? What do you think of that, Connor?
Pretty big, isn't it?
Bigger than the one you have at home, huh? You want to touch it?
You want to go sit in the driver's seat? Yeah, go on. That tie is bigger than you.
Okay, go. Oh, hey, what do you think of that, buddy? What do you think of that? Every time we drive by, you say, I want to go there. Here you are. What do you think of that?
Connor, how old are you? You're three? My God, you're big. I would have said 4 or 5.
I know.
Sheesh. Eat you out of house and home?
Touch the steering wheel, I know. Touch the steering wheel.
What?
Touch the steering wheel.
There you go.
There you go,
you can touch it. You can move it. It's not on. Nothing's going to happen.
What do you think of that? He's amazed. You want to drive it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, do that. You got another 20 years for that.
Yeah, they all do.
What do you point to that?
That's where all the magic happens. Mission control.
You want to see the ladder?
Yeah.
Up on its wheels and with the jacks out. It'll probably lift you almost 110 feet in the air.
What do you think of that?
110 feet gets a little hairy.
You ready to see the rest of the truck? Okay.
Yeah, all the things I need to tie into a hydrant and all that stuff, those are just more hoses tied into the hydrant. And here we have our hand tools. the stuff you need when you're working on a tower truck, the main job is to go up on people's roofs. We have all these axes and stuff to cut holes in the roofs, lets the smoke and the air out of there, so that the firefighters actually working on the fire can see. And then back there we keep some foam and stuff. And that's good for car fires.
The firefighters back.
The what?
Firefighters.
Firefighter?
Yeah.
That's a firefighter.
I am. I'm just off today. I got off this morning, but I had stuff to do, so I had to come back.
Hey.
So that's why I don't have any of my gear and stuff.
Yeah, and they don't wear it all the time, Connor.
That's where we keep the jaws of life. Jaws of life are right there and ready to go in case somebody gets into a car accident or something like that. We need to use them to cut them out of there, help them out of a jam. This truck is too big to make it down some of the roads and stuff. So we'll have to actually use ground ladders to put them up to people's windows, help them get out, rescue them, that kind of thing. I'm trying to keep it simple. Well, on this side, this is where we'll use some of our other cool tools. This is a big fan. That helps blow all the residual smoke and stuff. We call that a vent fan. And it's vent that, if your house was on fire, we'd use that to blow all the smoke on out of there. But after the fire was out. And we do keep an extra chainsaw in there.
What do you think of that? A lot more involved than just driving a truck, right. Huh?
Those are just some extra lights and stuff. And then we got some extra breathing bottles and some extra extinguishers and stuff. And in there, we got a portable generator. So that on a fire scene, if your house was on fire or something and we had to cut the power, we'd be able to work all our electricity and make everything plug in. And these are just some more hand tools to help you clean up and stuff. Actually, somebody didn't clean that up very good. We'll have to get back and clean that thing up again. Because that thing was used and not really cleaned very well. So how's that?
Good.
Yeah?
Do you know what this is right here?
Yeah.
Right here. What's that? What?
Ambulance.
Good. Very good.
Atta boy. That's my son's favorite. I can't get him out of this thing. You want to look at that? Yeah? Now, this is a backup one. This one's kind of old. But we do, in case any of the other ones have to go out for service or anything, we'd be able to use this one. But there's nothing to be afraid of in here. All we do is try to help people if they get sick or injured in any way. But there's nothing in here to ever be afraid of. Alright?
What do you think of that, Connor? You've never been in an ambulance before, have you? Is this the first time?
That's cool.
Yeah.
You never want to be a patient in one of these.
Yeah, that would be bad.
Yeah.
There you go.
Get next to that tire. I'll show you that tire is bigger than you.
Yeah, go right up next to it.
Can I take a picture of you next to the tire, Connor?
Yeah.
Go right up next to that tire. What do you think of that? It's bigger than you.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, Connor.
Sometimes people get lost in the woods, or woods fires, whatever. We'll have to use this stuff to actually get in there and either rescue people or stuff like that. Yeah. You want to sit the mule? The mule's pretty cool. That's more your size.
Yeah. You can bring that and put that in the backyard.
Yeah. That thing will go about, I don't know, 45, 50 miles an hour.
Really?
So that's pretty cool. Actually, I don't know if it will with the tanks on there anymore, because we put the, there's two 35-gallon tanks on there and with it loaded up with the water. I don't know, I think that's probably going to put a drag on it. I'd have to assume. But it can move. Isn't that cool?
You want to drive it so bad, don't you?
Yeah. I do too. It's fun. We love train a day on that thing.
They can see going, bringing this over. We live across the street from the gravel pit over there.
Oh, no kidding.
Oh. That's what you like. You like the lights?
Red flashing lights. You want to come down and look at them?
Look at the lights.
Those we call it a special dive team, and they come and pick this thing up. What do you guys got near you? Blood pond?
Yeah.
Yeah?
And there's the helmet.
Mm-hmm. That kind of looks like yours. That kind of looks like yours. Try that one on.
Wow.
How's that?
What do you think of that one?
It's a little bit heavier than a little bit heavier than yours, huh?
Yeah.
And this is where the guys keep their gear lockers.
Is that where you keep yours at home? Where do you keep this?
You gotta keep it at the ready in your locker. So you always know where it is.
What do you think? You ready? You ready to go?
No.
No?
Yeah.
No,
we usually get that.
Can you get up there?
Yeah.
You can, can't you? Beep the horn. Whoa! Good dude. Is this your favorite truck? You like it? You look nervous. Are you nervous?
He's overwhelmed.
One more time. Oh. Oh, I don't know. I don't drive a truck like this.
What's that, buddy? What do those buttons do? Basically, they'll turn on the flashing lights and the generator and stuff. I don't drive this one all that much. This is mostly for the special ops guys. But I fill it up every now and then.
Alrighty.
When it needs to be filled.
You ready for lunch?
No.
I'm ready for lunch.
Come on, this gentleman has to get to work. Hello? Ready? What? Where are you going?